Hello and welcome to the review of Open Heaven's Daily Devotional for Thursday, 3rd December 2020. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for a beautiful day as this one. Thank you for keeping us. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for teaching us. Thank you for drawing us close to you. We ask, O God, that as we review today's daily devotional together, your presence will be with us in the name of Jesus. Change our lives by the power of your word in the name of Jesus. Draw us closer to you, O God, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for answered prayers, for we've prayed in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Today's topic is everyone has enemies. Everyone has enemies. And our Bible text is taken from Psalms 7 verse 1 to 11. Psalms 7, 1 to 11. I read from the New King James Version. O Lord my God, in you I put my trust. Save me from all those who persecute me, and deliver me, lest they tear me like a lion, rending me in pieces, while there is none to deliver. O Lord my God, if I have done this, if there is iniquity in my hands, if I have repaid evil to him who was at peace with me, or have plundered my enemy without cause, let the enemy pursue me and overtake me. Yes, let him trample my life to the earth and lay my honor in the dust. Verse 6. Arise, O Lord, in your anger. Lift yourself up because of the rage of my enemies. Rise up for me in the judgment you have commanded. So the congregation of the people shall surround you. For their sakes, therefore, return on high. The Lord shall judge the peoples. Judge me, O Lord, according to my righteousness and according to my integrity within me. O Lord, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end, but establish the just, for the righteous God tests the hearts and minds. My defense is of God, who saved the upright in heart. God is a just judge, and God is angry with the wicked every day. May the Lord bless the reading of his words in Jesus' name. Amen. Our memory verse today is taken from Exodus chapter 23 verse 22. Exodus 23:22. And it reads, But if thou shalt indeed obey his voice and do all that I speak, then I will be an enemy unto thine enemies and an adversary unto thine adversaries. And this memory verse really puts a spotlight on the fact that we do have enemies, we do have adversaries, we do have people who are not necessarily in line or in tune with the things that we are in line with or with the things that we are in tune with. In fact, quite a number of times, there are people who don't like us for reasons they themselves cannot even tell. And they might go to any length to cause us harm or not to wish us well wherever it is that they are, you know, watching us from or interacting with us from. Some people would believe that as children of God we don't have enemies. You know, quite a number of people will say, oh, those who are enemy focused, always praying against enemies here and there. Well, the truth is, the enemies shouldn't be the focus. God should be our focus every single minute, every single moment of our lives. However, we need to know that enemies do exist, and for that reason, live a life conscious of the fact that it is the protection of God, it is the mercy of God that actually keeps us safe from the enemies of our lives. You know, some people would probably feel that when we keep thinking about enemies, it is negative thinking. No, you're not supposed to think about enemies perpetually, but you need to know that yes, there are enemies. In fact, number one of the enemies we have as children of God, the moment you move from the camp of the enemy to God's camp, the moment you translate from darkness into light, your number one enemy is the devil. The Bible calls him your enemy, your adversary, the devil, who is is as a roaring lion, going to and fro, seeking who it might devour. And when you devour something, you completely take it up. It's completely wiped out. It's not noticeable, not recognized. That is what the devil wants to do to us. But it is the mercy of God and the grace of God and the protection of God that keeps us. I pray that that protection will never be taken away from our lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Proverbs chapter 14 verse 20 says, "The poor is hated even of his own neighbor, but the rich hath many friends." This also shows that when our lives are not going well, when we don't have all the things, all material things that we are supposed to have, it could cause hatred for some people. Yes, because some people could like us, you know, just for the selfish interest, for what we're able to gain from us, from the resources that we're able to give to them. Everybody likes the person who comes bearing gift. And everybody doesn't like the person who is always seeking to receive, or asking for something, or looking for someone to give him something or bless him every single time. And I pray that you will be that rich person who is always giving, because indeed it is more blessed to give than to receive, and you will continually be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So it means also that if we are rich, if we are successful, if we are doing well in every area of our lives, we would attract friends to ourselves. We need to be careful as well, because it's not everyone who is with us that is in the same direction that we are going. However, with the presence of God in us, with the discerning spirit of God in our hearts, we are able to know those who are truly friends, or those who are staying or lurking around to harm us. Pray that God will continue to protect us in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. David said in Psalm 23 verse 5, David said, "Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of my enemies." There are people who don't like you just because you've attained the success that you have. The people who don't like you because God has blessed you richly. But our God even prepares a table before us in the very presence of this kind of people to show forth his glory, to show us forth as people that he has blessed. The Bible says that my cup runs over right in the presence of my enemies, meaning that it is not also right for us to have a mindset of trying to cover the blessings of God in our lives because we don't want someone to see it, or we don't want this person to notice it. I don't want to attract enemies to myself. Look, there are no things that you can do that is able to protect you from the enemy except God protects you. If God does not watch over a city, they that watch over it do so in vain. I pray that we will never lose the watching eyes of God over our lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Psalm 68 verse 1 says, "Let God arise, let his enemies be scattered." Anyone who is our enemy is also the enemy of God. So it means when God arises in your life, then he scatters his enemies, which are also equally your enemies. And we need to look at it. What makes God arise? One thing that makes God arise is praises. When we praise God, it rises up to inhabit our praise. And the moment God arises, there is a scattering of the enemy. There is confusion in the camp of the enemy. Our enemies scatter when we praise God. And I want you to develop that habit, that you cultivate that habit perpetually, of being in a state of praise, in a state of worship, in a state of adulation and adoration of God. Because when you are praising God perpetually, it's constantly arising in your life, constantly arising for you, constantly arising in your situation. And that means your enemies will be constantly scattered, and they won't be able to harm you. Scattered in seven ways and even more. I pray that that will be our portion always in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Finally, the Bible says in 2 Chronicles chapter 20, from verse 21 to 22, it says, "And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, and that should and that should praise the beauty of holiness as they went out before the army, and to say, praise the Lord, for his mercies endures forever. And when they began to sing and to praise the Lord set ambushment against the children of Amnon, Moab, and Mount Seir, which were come against Judah, and they were smitten when the children of God praised him, even in a time of war, in a time of disturbance, even when people who were clearly stronger than them were against them. The Bible says that God himself set an ambush for the enemy of his people. God will set an ambush for your enemy today in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to go ahead and use this time to just say, Father, I praise you. Lord, I praise you. With all my heart, I praise you. With everything inside of me, I praise you. Arise, O God, and inhabit my praise. Arise, O God, and let every enemy of my life be scattered. Lord, teach me to praise you even more than I do in the name of Jesus. Help me to live a life of perpetual praise, a life of someone who gives thanks to you every single time in the mighty name of Jesus. Teach me to praise you, O God. Give me a heart of gratitude, and I will continually thank and praise you. And as I praise you, you will inhabit my praises, and your presence will never be scarce in my life in the name of Jesus. I pray today, Father, arise, scatter every enemy of my life, every enemy of my destiny, every enemy of my vision, every enemy of my earth, every enemy of my family, every enemy of my life. Arise, O God, let your enemies be scattered in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given praises. Amen. Have a wonderful day. God bless you.